Well, hello, folks. What's going on? Hey, it's Mike Carlucci. It's all about Mike Carlucci's The Bottom Line as we're getting set here for another fast, cool episode. Yes, it's time to talk baseball. And with me, of course, here he is, the man from Chicago, former USA baseball coach. He's also the WBSC technical commissioner for all the big international baseball events around the world. And also, he's got a really cool show, which we'll talk about a little bit later, called Baseball Outside the Box. Let's bring him in, Mr. Chicago. He's a tough guy. You got to be if you live in Chicago now these days. Here he is, Peter Caliendo. Hi, Peter.
Mr. Carlucci, come stai? Stai bene?
Oh, molto bene. By the way, Mike Carlucci's The Bottom Line is part of the CBI Network, bringing it to you, Carlucci Broadcast International. Once again, we have our fine folks from Pabst Blue Ribbon, PBR, bringing you today's episode. Well, Peter, here we go. We chatted just a few days ago or so. We got two back-to-back shows here taking place. Got a big barrel full of information for baseball. That actually was our official second episode on baseball. Now this is our third one, as we're going to just go quickly here because we have about 20-25 games to go. And it's a sprint. Here we go. And this was the trading deadline day and evening. And Peter, before we do that, give me a couple of your thoughts of some of the teams that you think got some gold and maybe some teams got silver and bronze. Who made out, you think, so far in this trading deadline?
Man, no doubt about it. Number one on the list are the Padres. Holy Moses, did they? Mike Clevenger, they picked up, and then they added a bunch of other guys. I think they're number one. I believe that Blue Jays did a pretty good job also. They needed to beef up their team a little bit, and looks like they did a pretty good job also.
Yeah, it looks like the Padres picked up six or seven guys. I mean, we're talking, and three or four of those are big-name players. You talked about Mike Clevenger. Let's see, they got a guy named Greg Allen. I think he's a prospect from Cleveland.
Mitch Moreland. Trevor Rosenthal. You know, boofed up there. That's their closer now. And Austin Nola, who was in the lineup today, drove in a run and scored a run.
Yeah, the Padres got, you said, Mitch Moreland. And who was the other player you said they got?
Trevor Rosenthal would be their closer.
Yeah, and those are two experienced guys, obviously, big-name players in the sense of experience and playoff experience, which is going to be very important with the Padres, probably will tackle the Dodgers for the top spot there in the National League. So some big playoff experience guys the Padres acquired, and I don't think they're through yet. Someone said they're looking for some other players to add to that big barrel full of talent they have now with Machado and Tatis Jr., and also Hosmer, and then your favorite guy. And you said this guy might be a possible candidate for Rookie of the Year. Is that Cronenworth?
Well, they mentioned it today on MLB Network. I mean, there'll be a few other guys battling him. But Cronenworth, man, he is battling. He's a left-handed hitter, and he's right there in the middle of the lineup doing a great job. Again, one of our players from what we call the USA Baseball National Team Identification Program when he was 16. And great to see him. Great kid. Deserves it. He's just having a great season.
Wow, the Padres, man. It's too bad the fans can't go out and see them, but nonetheless, they could grab the teletube, watch them on online or TV, and of course, hear them on the radio. Well, let's see some other teams. The Rockies are trying to hang in. Remember, the Rockies got off to a great start. They were like 12-3. Then they just went right into the big toilet there for a bit. I think they lost like 10 out of 13. They're still hanging in there. They've actually upped it a little bit. They're like in third place right now in the NL West. They picked up a very good player defensively, and he does have a bat. His bat can be hot at times. Kevin Pillar, and he's a great defensive player. And the Padres, I mean the Rockies, I should say, that team needs great defense and speed out there in the outfield because those balls over there in the Mountain High State, they travel quite far.
And surprisingly, I thought Lance Lynn was going to go, and I thought, you know, somebody like the Dodgers, who definitely need another starter. You know, they were quiet here in the trade deadline, and also with the Yankees were quiet. That was kind of a surprise. The White Sox, I guess I thought for sure the White Sox would go after a pitcher, maybe even a starter, but they're doing pretty good. 21-13 in first place. So they decided to hold off. The Blue Jays is the team that I like because they already had a very good young lineup and they picked up a few guys. It looks like Robbie Ray from the Diamondbacks, left-handed pitcher, Ross Stripling, pitcher. So they added their pitching staff, and Taiwan Walker they added to their lineup.
Yeah, Stripling was with the Dodgers. He was their fourth or fifth starter in that rotation. Had a couple of good games. Sometimes he'd have an off day that he would give up six or seven runs, but he's been pretty consistent for him, especially out of the bullpen as well and in mid-relief. Now, I don't know if you remember, Peter. Remember, I think just about maybe a couple months before spring training started, the Dodgers and Angels had a big swap deal. They were going to trade Jock Peterson, Stripling, and one other player to the Angels, and I'm trying to remember who the Angels were going to give up. It was a pretty good player. It might have been Calhoun or one of those guys and a couple of prospects, but for some reason the deal got axed at the last minute, because with Jock Peterson, he might have been able to thrive hitting behind Rendon, Mike Trout, and Pujols, and Stripling could have added some experience and a little sturdiness to that pitching rotation. As you know, the Angels are lacking right now, unfortunately. But Stripling to the Blue Jays. It's a Blue Jays. You're going to make a run for it. They've been playing some great ball. We kind of chatted about it in the previous show here before this one. Let's see what else. Oh, the Mets are trying to hang in there. They think they can make a run. They just picked up three big bats. Robinson, is it Chirino?
Chirino.
Yeah, the S is silent. So Robinson Chirino. Mm-hmm. Todd Frazier. And a young man named Castro. Let's see if you get his last name. Miguel Castro. And the Orioles, check that. It was actually a three-way deal. Three teams were involved. So the Mets got Robinson, Chirino, and Cash. And the Rangers have a player to be named later. And the Mets will get Todd Frazier back. He played there, I think, if it wasn't last year, the year before. Rangers will get player to be named later. And that other player, Miguel Castro, they picked up for the Orioles for relief pitchers. A right-hander for a left-hander, Kevin Smith of the Mets, now goes to the Orioles, and with some cash and another player to be named later. So the Mets trying to hang in. I think if they get those bats all healthy, I mean, they got a pretty solid lineup there.
They got to get it going because they're 5.5 games out. They got the Phillies ahead of them. They got the Marlins, who added Marte, and they've got the Braves ahead of them, obviously, at 20-14. So not going to be easy for them.
Yeah, I see your Cubs picked up an old veteran. He's not really old, but he's been around a while. is it Cameron Maben? Is that his name? He played on quite a few teams. He actually had some spark in his bat. I think he played a year or so with the Marlins, and he also played with the Padres. I think the Giants had him in the system there for a little bit until they released him. I think he had a little altercation outside of baseball. But nonetheless, the Cubs picked him up from the Detroit Tigers for a prospect named Zach Short.
Was that today?
That was today.
It was today, because prior to that, the Cubs picked up another power-hitting right-hander who played for the Cardinals but was with the Rays.
Okay.
And who was that?
Huh. I know there's so much going on. It's hard to keep track here. Let's see. Did the Oakland A's – I'm sorry, go ahead. You're going to say.
No, they did that. The Cubs did that the other day. I'm just looking to see. Yeah, Maben was today. And trying to see who the Cubs traded. Boy, I should know that off the top of my head.
Now, did the Oakland A's make a deal? Because they're, right now, the marquee team, the American League, along with the Tampa Bay Rays. I don't see the A's. Obviously, they don't want to give up anything good. I thought maybe they'd try to pick up a veteran, which they probably did. I just don't see anything here on the list. Checking. Oh, by the way, the A's and Mariners have postponed their games through Wednesday. I don't know if it's a weather thing or is it something to do, I don't know, with all this stuff going on. Speaking of games being postponed, of course, last week, out of the courtesy and out of respect for the situation that happened in Kenosha, Wisconsin, the NBA canceled their, or I should say postponed their playoff games on, I believe it was either Tuesday or Wednesday, maybe a combination of both days. And the MLB, Major League Baseball, did the same thing. The West Coast teams postponed their games, did not play Tuesday night, and then the East Coast games did the respect on Wednesday afternoon and Wednesday evening, East Coast time, postponed their games out of respect for Black Lives Matter and the situation that happened in Kenosha, Wisconsin. So anyway, oh, here we go.
Michael.
Just found it.
Yeah, Rays outfielder Jose Martinez went to the Cubs.
Okay.
That's who was with the Cardinals, power, right-handed power hitter.
And I just saw here the A's made a deal for Mike Minor, a crafty left-hander, been around, veteran, and at times he gets on a roll. He's one of those tough guys, tough pitchers, pitches a lot of innings, gives you a lot of innings, and gives you a lot of sweat and tear, and keeps that bullpen healthy and relaxed because he can give you a lot of innings. So the A's picked up something they could add to their arsenal there in the pitching rotation. They made a deal. So the Rangers pretty much sold everybody because they're not in it right now. They're rebuilding like a lot of teams. So, yes, Tampa Rays, my goodness, they beat the Yankees again?
Again, the seven, they beat them 7 out of 8 this year. The Rays are amazing. They are, 25-11, and I think that's might be 26-11 now, if I'm correct.
Wow, they're chasing the Dodgers for the best record. I think the Dodgers were at one time 26-10. And I think they have an off day today. By the way, I just want to say, I want to say salute to you.
Huh? Hey, speaking about salute, how come you don't have any pasta sponsors? We got to get some Italian pasta sponsors.
We'll get some on the next show. I guarantee it. Okay.
All right.
Not a problem. We got all kinds of good sponsors. We'll get them going. So anyway, so good. Trading deadline. It's of course not as heavy and wild with a full 162 game season. Usually it's more dramatic. But this is actually pretty good for a quick 60 game season. We only have 24 games left for some. Of course, the Cardinals, I think the Marlins have close to over 30. They're still trying to catch up. But yeah, excited for those Padre fans. My goodness. And I feel so bad for the Angels. They lost again today to Seattle. Seattle's been on a roll. Of course, they're out of it too. But the Angels, disappointing. I think they're like 12 games that are 500. Oh, didn't see that going at all. Didn't see that
not
going
at all. How about Miami? They're 3 games out. And they added, looks like what, Marte from
Yeah, he had some good years with Pittsburgh. And I think he was with Arizona. So the Diamondbacks are unloading some right now. And they made a trade. So I guess Miami thinks they're in it. Like you said, I mean, anything could happen. 20 games, they're at 500. They're three games back of the Braves, tied with Philadelphia for second place. Then, actually, the Mets are only a couple games back of Philly and Miami. So, looks like Washington's calling it a day. They're just going to go hide out and hit the basement and then get ready for a big 2021 season, it looks like.
Just keep celebrating from last year.
Yeah, stretch it out as long as you can. So, And in the Central Division, I mean, like I said, don't count the Cardinals out because they got a great team. They're always in it, for years and decades. I mean, Cardinal baseball is just like Yankee baseball in the sense of always in it. And they're just 3 games back of the Cubs, but they're still 8 games behind on total games played, matching the Cubs. So the Cardinals, I know they're going to have a lot of doubleheaders to catch up on, but hey, if they're healthy and solid, I don't see them making any deals, though, but I guess they're pretty happy with what they got. I guess the Dodgers are pretty happy. I thought maybe they'd try to pick up, like you said, they're looking at Lance Lynn from Texas, and that could still happen. We haven't – I mean, it's a ways to go before the deadline is over here. But the Dodgers, I thought, would probably pick up an arm or two because they obviously gave up an arm with sending Stripling to the Blue Jays. And they're solid in their lineup, so they don't need to add any bats. I mean, if they do that, just putting extra frosting on the cake, which I think they got too much frosting as it is.
They actually have somebody, and I always thought, Jock Peterson's a perfect guy to trade to try to get some pitching because they've got enough in their lineup where they can trade him.
Yeah, especially they got too many outfielders, and Peterson or Pollock, they could unload one or the other. Mm-hmm. They got good defense out there anyway if they unloaded Pollock or Peterson, and mainly those guys with the designated hitter being in both leagues, either Peterson or Pollock, I believe, mainly is in the designated hitter role. So it'll be interesting to see what happens here in the remaining hours of the trading deadline. So moving in, before we get back into who we like here in the next 2024 games, all the way racing to the end, some sad news. A couple days ago or so, a very good gentleman, I never got a chance or the honor to meet him, but I heard he was nothing but a terrific gentleman, a fantastic, talented actor, and so good with charity, with children, and no one knew that this gentleman was battling illnesses ranging from the cancer he had and the tearing of his body with the chemotherapy and the surgeries. Chadwick Boseman passed away at the age of 43. In his short amount of time in the movie business, has done some quality work, Peter. He played Jackie Robinson in the film that came out about 6-7 years ago called 42. And Jackie Robinson Day was just, of course, back in April, but they celebrated Jackie Robinson Day here the last couple of days or so, last couple of games, everyone's been wearing number 42 behind their jersey. But Chadwick Boseman, he did so many great things with charity, with these children's charities, children battling cancers and illnesses like Chadwick. Even though Chadwick was sick, and he would still go out there and visit the kids and give them spark and smiles and positive vibes and bringing them all kinds of cool gifts and things like that. And no one knew that he was diagnosed in 2016. And unfortunately, passed away a handful of days ago from the horrible, insidious disease of colon cancer. And for those watching, just want to give a quick 5-second spiel. You know, get yourself scoped. It's not a big deal. In fact, if you're 50 or older, definitely do it. But I think now with all the chemicals in the air and all the things we're eating, that a lot of if you're not eating a lot of natural foods, if you are eating processed foods, please, if you got any kind of history, go out when you're 40 or 45, get yourself scoped. It's real easy. It's not that big of a deal. You drink the fluids. There's no pain. In fact, when you do get the procedure done, it's like a quick nap. You're out for 15, 20 minutes and bang, it's done. Get it, save your life, and get someone else in your family to get scoped. Get that colonoscopy, because it's very important to save your life and get it done. Basic.
Absolutely. Great advice. And what a great young man. It sounded like he was a real private person. Mm-hmm. People loved him. Rest in peace. What a great actor. Like you said, in 42 and some other movies. I know I enjoyed 42, man. He was really good.
Yeah, his really big film was Black Panther, which was a blockbuster film for Marvel and Disney. And Black Panther, big box office records. And they were getting... In fact, that movie got nominated for Best Picture, one of the first superhero movies to be nominated for Best Picture. In fact, it was on television last night. ABC did a nice little coverage of the film and some honorarium of some actors and other guest stars giving their thoughts and praise to that gentleman. He also played James Brown in a film called Get On Up. It's the story of James Brown. And also he played one of the first attorneys for African-American attorneys back in the day. Thurgood Marshall, he portrayed that character as well. So this guy did some really great quality films, such a superstar and such a tragic loss at only the age of 43. He was going to be 44 in November. He had so much life ahead of him, and he offered so much life and praise and quality, just a quality person. And like you said, rest in peace. And such a tragic day when I heard he passed away, because nothing but great things about him.
And folks, enjoy your life. Don't worry about, next year or 2 years from now. You never know when your time is up, man. Mm-hmm. Enjoy it. Be good to people. Have a great time. Mm-hmm. And hopefully you're all doing something you enjoy in life. But, it's tough to hear. That news.
Yeah, and he had such a connection to baseball. That's why we brought it up, because he did such a terrific job portraying a heroic monarch of a person in the great late Jackie Robinson. So. Again, Chadwick Boseman, rest in peace, and condolences to all his family and his friends and his wife, who they just got married, I believe, either weeks or months before he passed away. So we send all our condolences and our prayers to her and the entire Chadwick Boseman family. So anyway, let's go back to Major League Baseball. The big race is on, so let's chat about who is going to be there at the end. And I know you like the Chicago White Sox. You like your Cubbies, too. I like those two. They're pretty solid. The White Sox did the right thing. They took a couple years off here, the last 3-4 years, just to rebuild. They got some great talent, solid lineup. Who's the kid at shortstop who you like, who smacks the ball in all kinds of parts of the field?
The White Sox?
Yeah, White Sox.
Tim Anderson. Boy, what a player
Anderson.
He is.
Timmy Anderson, man. That guy, he has such great vision. If someone says, hey, hit that ball to right field, he'll just hit it there. He'll hit it wherever you want. He's a solid player, and they got a solid pitching staff. Congratulations to Giolito, good Italian, good Paisan. He got a no-hitter, so the first no-hitter. It's a shame no fans to cheer him on, but nonetheless, he's there with his teammates. Oh, by the way, speaking of Italian players, I believe there was a trade a couple of days ago. Tommy La Stella.
Yes, to Oakland.
There's a guy. Yeah, okay, Oakland didn't. They've got a pretty solid lineup. They didn't need to acquire anybody, but they did. There's a good backup, and he's a solid teammate, solid clubhouse guy, Tommy La Stella from the Angels.
Great character guy, too.
Yeah, was off to a good start for the Halos, but since the Angels overall were not off to a good start, they unloaded him to their rival, the Oakland Athletics. So Cubs and White Sox. Yankees will get their together, eventually get those players back. Of course, Stanton is out and Judge is out and one of their pitchers is out for a little bit. But the Rays, man, watch out for those guys. Right now, I would say Tampa or Oakland from the American League, if things were going to be scored off right now. Those two teams are solidly built through the farm system. From every point of the field, defensively and offensively, pitching staff, solid, good closers. Nothing wrong with those two teams. Good managers, good teammates, good clubhouses. good management from upstairs. So Tampa and Oakland, that's my two, unless the Yankees kind of get off the schneid. I think Houston it could be streaky and get back in it, but they've had so many personal issues, you know, with the issue with the cheating and all that. I think they're going to have to take a year off. I mean, they'll make the playoffs, but I think they'll get knocked out. Let's see, who else is that? Minnesota got hot, and they got some great bats out there, but I think the pitching is kind of lulling a little bit. Cleveland could be a silent killer. That's all I got to say about the American League. National League, I'm going, obviously, the Dodgers, unless they just kind of go to sleep. Padres could be right on their tails, and they could wrestle them to the ground more ways than one. They just picked up a big load of guys pitching and hitting. And let's see, Cubbies, like I mentioned earlier. Let's see, who else could be in there? We talked about the Braves. If they get healthy, I just don't see the Mets or Phillies doing anything. I think they're still behind the window, if you want to say. And Cardinals, unless the Cardinals, out of that 9-10 games they have still left to play, unless they make a mark with those games, I got to go with the Cubbies in that division all the way. So Dodgers, Padres, Cubbies, Cardinals maybe, Braves. We mentioned the Marlins made some deals, but I just don't see the Marlins. I think they're just playing over their heads. I think they're going to fail at the end. And the Rockies, unless – well, they got some good defense. We're picking up Pilar, but that pitching, they still just can't get that pitching staff intact. They might have one or two good guys, but the rest just throw too much cheese and too much meat over the plate.
It's going to be tough for Colorado to come back 8 games with 20-some games left. They're 8 out. I personally think that the Padres added a lot of players. I think they're going to be better than the Dodgers. I think they'll take care of the Dodgers. I like the Padres better. Love the Cubs, and I love Atlanta. Obviously, they're in first place. I just don't see any other team. You know, like you said, maybe St. Louis might have a chance there. Other than that, in National League. And then the American League, I mean, you know, our team, Tampa, yeah, how could you not? Tampa's organization is just incredible. What they're accomplishing at that low payroll is just astonishing. And they've had some players, some pitchers on the IL, which is even more amazing. But you got to look at Toronto. They added a little bit, and Toronto could slip in there. White Sox, obviously. Cleveland, possibly. Oakland's always going to be in the playoffs. So I think you hit those right on the button. It's going to be interesting. It'll be a lot of fun to see. It's going to be tough. The National League is the one that's going to be so close because there's so many teams that are pretty close. I think the National League is going to be up for grabs.
Yeah. Well, that's what I was saying when I was going through my teams. I agree with you. Rockies are not going to catch the Dodgers, but I was thinking maybe the Rockies can hang in there as a solid wild card team. Now you're probably going, "Hey, Mike, how come you didn't talk about your Giants?" Well,
I was wearing your jersey.
My Will Clark jersey from the 1980s and early 90s. I was thinking the Giants had a little bit of a flirt there when they got that 7-game winning streak, and then they came back and beat the Dodgers on that Monday or two. I think it was Monday they played. It was a thrilling victory, and I thought, well, if they can, you know, keep going, but the postponement of that Tuesday game. They had to play a doubleheader on Wednesday, so it's 2 7-inning games. And yeah, that could throw you off, and the Dodgers have better pitching, so that's why the Dodgers just boom swept that doubleheader. I mean, unless the Giants get another winning streak in there, they can go ahead of the Rockies. I mean, like I said, they'll be a wild card team, but I just don't see them doing anything. So I think it'd be the Rockies or Giants probably for that last wild card team. But like you said, the Rockies aren't going to catch the Dodgers. The Padres, they could, because remember, they got to play the Dodgers 3 more times. So that'll make a mark there if they can do something. Cubs, nobody's going to catch them. East Division, I think the Braves have that solidly. So I just think there's, what, 8 teams, right? So let's go Dodgers, Padres, Cubs, Braves. I'm going to go Cardinals. That's 5. And then it's going to be Rockies and or Giants or Marlins. So I gave 9 right there. So it'll be 8 of those 9. We'll make it. American League, Tampa, Yankees. Let's see. Chicago White Sox. Yeah. Cleveland. I'm going to say, I think Minnesota for some reason is just going to run out of gas for some reason.
Oakland.
Oakland.
Houston, possibly.
Houston, probably. So is that 8? I think that's 8. If not, then throw in Minnesota if that's not 8. Those are the teams. And oh, you know what? We did mention earlier. You know, Toronto could sneak in there.
Toronto's the one I like.
Yeah, that's your team. You like Toronto and Tampa. Yeah, Toronto could kind of sneak in there if they get a big winning streak here in the next 20, 25 games. And they're one of the teams, too, are kind of behind on volume of total games. So look out for Toronto. They could be the one that kind of – could sneak in past Minnesota or Houston. It just depends. We'll see what goes on. I think once the Yankees get their guys back, they'll be top notch, and it'll be a run for the money for Tampa, the Yankees, and the Oakland A's probably. So there you have it.
Michael, let's remind our fans, when it comes playoff time, a couple rules will not be in effect, right? There won't be no extra inning rule in the playoffs?
Yeah, I think it's straight on.
Straight regular?
Yeah, straight regular. And what about the DH? Are they going full DH in the playoffs?
I think DH is staying, I believe, all the way through.
Okay, National League as well? Okay.
Yes.
That'd be good because keeps the pitchers focusing a little bit more and don't have to worry about, you know, getting up to the plate. But, yeah, this starting the extra innings with the runner on second base, it's cool for now because of the short season, and it's great for international play. And I think they should embed it into maybe college.
Right.
But right now it's good for 60 games. But once we get into the playoffs, once we get to 162
next year,
go back to full extra innings. You know,
absolutely. Agree.
Yeah. So what do you got going on, Peter? You got your show, Baseball Outside Box. Folks, you should tune in. He's got it on Facebook Live. He's got it on YouTube. He's got his own website. It's a great show. This guy gets all kinds of cool baseball people. It'd be former players, former coaches, former managers, current managers, current trainers, and international baseball reps. And he's got a show, if not every day, at least every other day. What do you got coming up on your show there, Peter?
Well, first of all, I think you'd be interested in this. I just had yesterday, last evening, Rick Matthews, speaking of Tampa Bay, the official scorer for the Tampa Bay Rays, 13 years official scorer in Major League Baseball. He's on the four-man committee that, you know, puts in the rules and makes adjustments and all that. And I thought it was interesting because, you know, a lot of podcasts, baseball podcasts, you really don't have an official score on there. And you as an announcer, you know how important an official score is.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not an easy job. There's a lot behind the scenes that go on. So we talked about the behind. And he's a college coach for over 28 years also at Eckerd College in Florida. So he's got the coaching background along with the, you know, scoring background. And he, you know, in Major League Baseball, you only have one scorer. And he has to do it all. And right now, Michael, he's got to do it from home. So from his office at home, he's not. They do not go to the stadium, the official scorers. So I thought it was very interesting. We talked about, you know, the man on second, how you score that as far as, you know, whose run that is. An interesting thing that I think you would really find very interesting, I did not know this, that in the 10th inning, the pitcher that starts the 10th inning, no matter what the result is, he said, is either the winning or losing pitcher.
Mm.
No matter what the result is. So if you gave up a run in the 11th and then, you know, and let's say you in the 12th you pitched, then you didn't pitch in the 13th and then somebody else came in. Yeah. No matter what the result is, you get the loss if you lost that game. And whoever won it that started the 10th gets the win.
Oh, wow. I didn't know. Okay. So that makes sense. That makes sense. Yeah, it's interesting, but it makes sense. Yeah, okay. Yeah, all these little snippets of the rule changes we got thrown at us here once the abbreviated season started. So, by the way, I believe that the Dodgers broke some kind of record. They have the most home runs in the month of August. Someone said they hit 57 home runs. That's a record, National League record. I'm not sure if it's a Major League record, but I know it's a National League record. So, a lot of home runs. That's like almost, two home runs or more per day, per game. So, yeah.
With that lineup, it doesn't surprise me. The Cubs broke a record, too. Three outfielders hit two home runs in each game in one game. And that's a Major League record.
Well,
so each guy hit two home runs hit by three outfielders in the Cubs game the other day.
Oh, that's a record. Okay. Yeah.
Each guy hit two homers.
Yeah. This heat, I tell you, the Dodgers are thriving playing in the West Coast. All these, the non-indoor stadiums are just taking advantage of the heat, man. It's been so hot here in Southern California, of course, other parts of the West Coast, just smoking the ball over the fence.
And compliments to you every time I see the commercial now, the Dodger with Kershaw. Mm-hmm. I hear your voice at the beginning of the commercial.
Oh, the Hankook Tires commercial.
Yeah, every time. Oh. I heard it last night. I'm hopefully getting chi-ching, chi-ching, you know, every one of those.
I hope my agent's not heisting the money from me. I got to get on him for that because I haven't seen him, and he's not – there's nobody in their offices. They're all working at home.
I was watching last night ready to go to bed. I was watching the game, and all of a sudden here comes the commercial. I'm thinking, Carlucci getting rich again. There you go.
I hope he's not rushing down to Vegas right now and taking my residual. So I have to get Mario and Luigi and Salvatore and the boys after him. So anyway. And before we close off, Pete – some sad news in the baseball world. Two Hall of Famers, two fantastic guys, not just contributing to the field, off the field as well. Tom Terrific, Tom Seaver of the New York Mets, the amazing Mets of 1969, passed away just a few days ago or so. So condolences to his family and his friends and former teammates. He was, by the way, a great broadcaster, good color commentator for ABC years ago as well, and NBC. And you just found out one of our other guys, our good guys, Hall of Famer, Lou Brock, passed away.
Yep. Yeah, unfortunately, it just happened. And, you know, when you lose two big Hall of Famers, icons like that, super individuals, as you said, you know, it's a sad day no matter what, but it's a sad day for baseball. Mm-hmm. I hope young players out there understand, man, you're so lucky playing the game. Play it hard, play it well, because those two guys did follow their legacy. They're great people. Yeah. Again, families, condolences, and a good matter of fact, got a chance to meet Lou Brock a long, long time ago with my mentor, Dick Birmingham, and what a great, great person. Talked to you all day. He was super. So condolences to the family, and rest in peace, guys.
Yeah, just a sad day with the Tom Terrific, Tom Seaver passed away now. Lou Brock, Tom Seaver, and Lou Brock. So that's what's going on. I mean, it's a very short season, but it's exciting in a sense. It's abbreviated excitement. And like I said, 2024 games. Who will be at the end? And I think Peter and I kind of gave our thoughts, and I'm sure a lot of you agree with some of the teams, and hopefully it's one of your favorite teams that get to the World Series. And we'll just have to wait and see. And we'll do at least one or maybe two more shows before the season ends. Of course, we'll do a playoff show as well. So, Peter, baseball outside the box. You got a lot of good guys coming on, so we'll look forward to watching you on Facebook Live and also YouTube Live and, of course, rebroadcast later. So, Peter, any last words before we see what's going on here for the downturn here of the 2020 baseball season?
Just that, man, it's been fun. I'm glad baseball's continuing. It looks like things are going well. Don't want to jinx it, but it's just been enjoyable to be able to relax because, you know, throughout this COVID time, you know, we all need sports. And, I just love watching the games. I know a lot of fans are watching them. And thank goodness we're watching some great games. So just like you said, if you join me on Baseball Outside the Box, I do have Graham Lloyd coming up, former big leaguer, left-handed pitcher from Australia. Mm-hmm. That'll be a good one. I've got Chris Carminucci, Arizona Diamondbacks scout, that'll be joining us. Peter Fady will be talking about vision. So we got a lot of great things coming up, Michael. And thanks again, man, for always having me on your show.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, Graham Lloyd, he's a great guy. That should be a lot of fun. We ran into some of our Australian cohorts there in Taiwan and Tokyo late last year. They had nothing but great things to say about Graham Lloyd, so that should be a fun show. I look forward to watching that. So in the meantime, folks, we appreciate you tuning in. By the way, please do subscribe. Tell your friends about our show. Any comments you have down there, please do that. But the main thing, please subscribe. We really appreciate that. Nonetheless, I'd like to thank my guest, Peter Caliendo, former USA baseball coach, WBSC, technical commissioner, and, of course, the host of the great baseball show called Baseball Outside the Box. Make sure you tune in. Thank you very much, Peter, for joining us. And, folks, remember, when you need to find what's going on, grab that big shovel, stick it deep in the ground, and dig it up. Pull that shovel up. You'll find something you like because that means you found the bottom line. Thanks for watching Mike Carlucci's The Bottom Line, brought to you by Pabst Blue Ribbon, PBR, bringing it to you. And, of course, all from the CBI, Carlucci Broadcast International. Remember, be fair, be equal, be safe, be healthy, take your vitamins, be nice to your family, be nice to your friends, and please wear your mask. Ciao for now.